Hello, today I'll be trying to code this animation. So what I have here is a wave animation, seven layers, and on each layer I have a multiple of six items. So let's see how we decode that. So first of all, let's say we have a starfish element, and we're going to take that and here just give it background black. Then we're going to give it a diameter, so the star is going to be 5 ms. So we're going to have width, and it's going to have the same height, and now we should be able to see it. And now let's make more of these. So here I'm going to have a number of layers. This is 7, and I'm going to have a number of arms for my starfish, which is 6. And then I'm going to have a total number of starfish, and this is going to be 1, the one in the middle, plus the number of arms, because we have a multiple of 6 per each. And then it's just the sum of the first n layers minus 1 numbers, which is n layers, the number of layers, times the number of layers minus 1, and this is half, it's half of this, so we're going to multiply with 0.5. Now we're going to have a container and a loop within it, and I'm going to have multiple starfish inside. So now let's switch permanently to the styling, and here I'm going to have a mixing that's going to create the shape, and it's going to depend on a few things. So I'm going to have a multiplying factor, which is 1 by default, then I'm going to have a precision, which is 90 by default, and then I'm going to have a relative maximum for my radius variation. So a relative maximum, so this is going to be 10%. Then I'm going to have an array, a list of points, which is empty at first. Now let's say we're going to have a number of arms here, 6, and we're also going to have a number of layers, which is 7. Here I'm going to have a constant m, which is the precision over the number of arms, and I just compute it here so I don't compute it multiple times afterwards. Then I'm going to have a base angle for my points, for the points that form the clipping path. So this is going to be 360 degrees over the precision. Then I'm going to have base angle for the radius of variation. So this is going to be the number of arms times the previous base angle. And now I'm going to have a loop. So for I from 0 through precision, here I'm going to have a current radius, and this current radius is 50% minus the relative maximum times 1 minus that factor times sine, a multiplying factor, and this is I modulo m, and this is multiplied with the base angle for the radius. And just to show you what this does, I'm going to call this mixin, so include shape, and here I'm going to have nth child I plus 1, and it's going to set with this current radius. Okay, and let's make this smaller so we can see stuff better. So here I have 6 peaks And these will correspond to the six arms of my starfish. But instead of going linearly down, they're going to go around the circle and they're going to create that sort of starfish effect. Now I'm going to have a current angle, and this one is going to be I times base angle for the points on the polygonal path. And now I'm going to add to the points list, which is its previous version, and 50% plus the current radius times cosine the current angle. And it's the same for the second dimension, except I'm going to have sine, not cosine. Okay, and after the loop, I set clip path polygon points. Okay, now what I need to do here is remove this height tweak and also remove that width tweak. And I have this, and it looks really good. Now, if I look at the compiled CSS, I have a lot of decimals. So let's reduce the number of decimals. Let's say that the default number of decimals is 2. So here, I'm going to put this in a parenthesis, multiply with, not a number of decimals, power of 10 to the number of decimals. And then, come on, stupid updates. Then I'm going to have round. Now, the thing here is that I'm trying to close some update windows. The thing here, this thing only records one window at a time, and at the same time I'm trying to close update windows, which is really shitty and something that I didn't want to happen while live coding. And here is minus the number of decimals. Okay, so now if I look at the compiled code, I'm having just two decimals at most, and here I can have one, and I think that still looks pretty good. So here I have at most one decimal, which is really good. Okay, so one more thing I want to show you here. If I do something like this, it's not going to look like a star at all. And it looks really ugly with just 30, and this is 80. And it's barely something like this, like 80, that it gets nice. And this relative maximum, just another thing that shapes the arms. And I can make it something like 5%, and it's going to be a lot smaller. Bring it up to 9. Okay, enough tweaking and playing. Now, position. Absolute. Top 50%, and the same thing for left. Okay, left. And then I'm going to have a margin, which is half of this diameter, minus half of this diameter, but half of this diameter is the radius. So R star is 0.5 V star. Okay, and here I'm going to have minus the radius. And now it's right in the middle. Okay, now let's start distributing stuff. So for layer from 1 to the number of layers. And here I'm going to start with a counter. Oh, come on, now a battery warning. This is great. It's not happening. Okay, let's plug this thing in. I'm going to have a counter. That's what I said I'd do. A counter which starts at 2, and here within. this loop. Okay, now I'm trying to unmute anything that may happen again. Okay, here within this loop, I'm going to increment this counter. But before that, I'm going to have another inner loop. So for I from 0 to the number of arms, here I'm going to have this counter plus the layer index times the number of arms. Okay. Now, one more thing. I'm going to set a base radius for my polygonal distribution. So I'm going to have R poly, and this thing is going to be the starfish radius, so R star times square root of 3. Okay. Then I'm going to have a base angle for this polygonal distribution, and this is going to be 360 degrees over the number of arms. And here I'm going to have a layer radius, which is going to be the layer index times the base radius. Okay, now here within this loop, I'm going to compute some angles. So I'm going to have the start angle. So for each edge of my polygon, I'm going to have a start point and an end point. So the angle for the start point is going to be the start angle, which is I times the base angle. And then I'm going to have an end angle, which is going to be I plus 1. And here I'm going to take these two, and I'm going to have x values, and these are going to be, so first of all, I'm going to have the initial margin, which is minus the starfish radius, and then I'm going to add the layer radius times cosine of the previous angle. And I'm going to have the same thing for the y coordinate, except this is going to be sine, not cosine. And I'm going to have y, not x here. Okay. So this is good. Now, the next thing, I'm going to have another inner loop. So for j from 0 to the layer index. And here I'm going to have a k, which is j over the layer index. And I'm going to compute an actual x position, which is 1 minus k times, outside parenthesis, the start x plus k times the end x. And I'm going to have the same thing for the y. So, not x, but y. And here I'm going to have nth child. And this is going to be n plus I times the layer index plus j. And this is going to be margin y x. Okay, so now I have my nice distribution there. Now, let's see what we do about the container. So let's collapse this whole thing. And we're going to have section here. And let's give it a background red so we can see stuff. And here I'm going to have a container size. And this one is going to be the number of layers minus the central one, so minus 1, times the polygonal radius, times square root of 3, over 2, times square root of 2. But over 2 and times square root of 2 means square root of 2 at the denominator, And then I'm going to have square root of 3 over 2, which is square root of 1.5. Okay, so here I'm going to set the width, that container size. And a height, which is the same. And I'm going to set position relative. Okay, now I think I can extend it by a bit. So let's, and that bit is a radius. So a starfish radius. So star. Okay, this looks good. And here I'm going to set overflow hidden. This is good. And now let's set some stuff on the body. So body display flex. And I'm going to have justify content center. And the exact same thing for the other dimension. And except this is going to be align items, but it doesn't work because I need to set a height that's the full height, so 100 viewport height units. Okay, now let's get rid of the scroll bar, so this is margin 0, and let's give it a background Gainsborough. Okay, this is it for the body, and make this white. Give it a box shadow. Let's do something like 0, 0, 2 pixels, dim gray, and 0, 0, 5 pixels. No, actually, make it 3 pixels, 1 pixel black. Okay, this works. Now, the last thing that I need to do here is morph keyframes, sorry. And I'm going to have to include shape of factor 1, and I'm going to set an animation duration T. And this is going to be 2 seconds. And I'm going to have an animation here. So animation, this is going to be morph. That animation duration is in out, infinite, alternate. And here, I don't want them to animate at the same time, so I'm going to have nth child n plus n, and I'm going to have animation delay is layer times the animation duration over the number of layers, so this should work, and it does. We got that effect. So yeah, this is it for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, just drop them in the comments below or send them on Twitter. And until next time.